One of the things you're often asked to do when applying for a research degree is to submit a research proposal along with your CV and copies of the certificates for your qualifications. Now, there's sometimes anxiety and confusion about what a research proposal is, and this short video aims to clarify that in a very basic and general way. There's a lot of help out there for you in the form of books and videos, and I strongly recommend that you look for that help and pay heed to the detailed advice you'll be offered there. Here, all I want to do is cover the absolute basics. First of all, you need to remember that a research proposal is not just your CV or a list of your achievements, but like any job application with a covering letter, it's a narrative, a story, which should tell its readers that you're up for the position. You are the perfect person for the job. And that means that you need to do whatever the institution and the position requires you to do. That's first and foremost. It overrides everything else. It's no good applying for a PhD in astrophysics if you write large chunks of the proposal talking about your experience in social work. That's rule number one, I guess. Every word must be relevant and contribute to the overall image of yourself as the perfect person for the task. So, what do you actually put into the proposal? Well, one helpful way to think of that is to remember a simple acronym. You may have heard of the four P's of marketing: price, product, promotion, and place. Well, your proposal needs to have three P's: person, project, and place. They don't need to be separate sections, but you do need to cover all these aspects. The person, the first P, is you. Your areas of expertise, your experience and interests. What's your academic background? Who influences you intellectually? What evidence of resilience can you give? For example, what long projects have you brought to fruition successfully? What skills have you developed? You might have skills acquired outside formal study that will be useful for your research proposal. Earlier, I said it was no good describing your experience in social work if you're applying for a PhD in astrophysics. But that experience might be invaluable if you have a degree in, say, English, and you're applying for a PhD in social work. Of course, you have to make your background and preparedness clear, but the whole proposal is actually a portrait of you. If the grammar or spelling are sloppy, or you use words wrongly in any part of your application, what does that say about you? Are you careful enough about communication for a PhD? Now, the second and most important part of the proposal, really, is the project. You need to make clear what your research question or questions are, how you're going to answer them, and whether you'll have access to the resources needed to answer them. Are you going to be able to do it, the project, in the time required? Now, a PhD is defined as an original contribution to knowledge. It's not just repeating what's already known in an obedient fashion. Making what you hope will be your original contribution to knowledge can be quite a challenge, and it's certainly not something you can dash off in half an hour. It'll probably take days, if not weeks, to think through properly. Now, in order to show that you are indeed planning to make an original contribution to knowledge, you need to prove, not just tell your readers, that you know the field you want to contribute to. That means you need to give a brief overview of the field, or at least give some background to it. And when you identify that field, you show a gap in knowledge that you want to fill. Of course, you won't know everything, and your readers will accept that. But you should give them evidence, not just claims, that show them that you know what you're doing. Your research questions must be derived from a clear knowledge of the field. Previously, I mentioned that it's important not just to articulate your research questions in a simple and transparent way, but also how you're going to answer them. Are you planning to binge watch serials on Netflix? That's not really going to help you achieve your research questions just by passively watching. You need to be able to generate and maintain information or formulate data and transform that data or information into knowledge. In other words, you need to be able to keep track of what you're learning and put it into a narrative. How are you going to do that? You may be using quantitative methods like counting the appearance of certain words or phrases in a defined corpus, or measuring the commonness of certain chemicals in healthy bees versus sick ones. Or you may use qualitative methods like interviewing to establish the social behavior of PhD students. Or you may use close reading to see what a text means, or a combination of methods. These are all ways of creating information and then generating knowledge. You need to make it clear in your proposal what methods you will be using and why they are the best ones to answer your research questions. Now, formulating a project is very hard, and it's certainly a good idea to write directly to a potential supervisor with a draft proposal, or at least an idea of what research question you're interested in. You may explain a bit about why you are the right person to answer those questions. And if you make contact with us in this way, you're already showing that you've thought about that last P, place, that I listed at the beginning of the video. Why is where you're applying to the perfect place to ask and answer your research questions? Are there resources there or nearby that you can use? A crucial resource will be your potential supervisors. Why would studying with these supervisors help you answer your research questions? That means looking them up, reading their publications, investigating them on social media, and asking around what they're like. That investigation of them may sound creepy, but you really do need to establish whether you'd get on with them. Finally, on rereading your research proposal before you submit, put yourself into the shoes of your readers. What's in it for them to accept you? Why should they care about your application? They can't help you because you're a nice person or an enthusiastic one in desperate circumstances, but they may be able to accept you if you've proved to them that you can indeed make a contribution to their field.